obviously these are not brand new harnesses. As we say over and over again, CanaDog runs our dogs. We train and race our own dogs. So these harnesses have been on and off a lot of dogs. In fact, these are in their eighth season, I think I mentioned, and we're still using them. And they are in great shape. You'll see the padding. Nothing is folded or twisted, which is very significant, especially when dealing with the rip stop, etc. Sometimes it tends to fold in and you end up getting really bad rub spots. You can see just how our harnesses hold up. Okay, this is Vader. And as I said, he is he's a Sepala Siberian, so he comes from a racing line of Siberians. He's not a show line of Siberian, but yet he still has that northern breed body type, that big undercoat, the thick neck. And so the thing with the collared style, you saw how short or how small the neck opening is. I wouldn't even want to attempt to get this on Vader's big head. As handsome as he is, he has a northern breed head and they're just bigger. And if I got this on him, it wouldn't be pleasant to get off. That's the big difference between the collared and the X-back on the Siberians. They're not a good fit. So what we'll do is we'll just grab the X-back harness here. And this actually is the harness he runs in. So a good way to put a harness on, this is what I typically do with some of the shyer dogs or the dogs that tend to get a little overexcited and they really want that harness on and they're going crazy, is what I'll do is I'll actually just straddle the dog and hold his hips with my knees. And I won't put a lot of pressure on him, I'll just settle him down a little bit. Vader is one of those dogs that wants to just get moving. So a real nice way to be able to put the harness over the face nice and comfortably is what I do is I take the two openings and I press them together. So basically the breastplate I fold it in half, and what that does is that creates one opening. And so basically you just take and you put it straight over the nose and pull it over nice and gently. Too easy. And again, as I said, he's been nursing a sore shoulder. He's a little older now. He's one of our retired dogs. So I'm going to be real gentle with bringing this down. I'm going to pull all the way down. He's going to put it on himself. Now, this is very important. If you were to be finished putting this harness on at this point, I think that you would probably go, oh my goodness, there's no way this thing fits. And this is what happens when a lot of you get them home. I know this because I get the emails and the phone calls. There's a couple of very important steps that have to be done after you put the harness on a very long-coated dog like this. One of them is hanging onto the harness and pulling all this fur through. Pull it through. Get it on there. And make it comfortable for them too. And then it's not pulling down like a bad ponytail. Okay? The next thing is to just shimmy this down. Make sure that all that fur is forward where it should be. And again, as we showed you with the collared fit on Mars, you don't know how it fits until they have weight into the harness, right? So if he's gonna pull ahead, this is gonna come all the way back, and again, it looks like a completely different harness fit now. So those are very important things when you're putting on the harness on a heavy-coated Siberian Northern breed type dog. Again, remember, pull the fur toward the neck and the harness back and fix it and make it comfortable for them. Then shimmy it back underneath the armpits and make sure all the fur is where it needs to be. Then give it a good pull and pull it out and see where it fits. All of these steps will ensure that the dog is comfortable in the harness, which is the most important thing. One of the most important fits on the harness is going to be your neck, and the other is going to be the length, obviously, so that it's not, again, rubbing down on the legs and it's coming up over across the hips. Right, Vader? Is it right?